Hello, beautiful singers. This is Valerie White-Williams and Vocal Splendor Studios. And today I would like to talk to you about the callback process of the voice. If you caught my last video, you realize that I made an audition video for the voice. I got an email from a casting producer right before Thanksgiving asking for any talent referrals for people who might want to audition for the voice. They came to Seattle this last weekend, and they only did private schedule auditions. Now, these private schedule auditions were in lieu of the open call, and everybody who had a private audition had to submit a video. So that video submission, which we did by invite, was like the open call first round. So getting called back into the private audition was like the callbacks. And if you go to the Voice website, you will see their criteria for the open call, which is a cappella, and then there's the criteria for the open call, which is three pop songs. So anyway, I went to that open call on Saturday. Not the open call. I went to the private edition, which is the callback. Now, with the callback, they ask you to either bring in an accompaniment track, or you can play piano or guitar for yourself, or uke, I guess, if you have it, or have someone come in and play for you. So I went in at my scheduled time, and I was at a studio in downtown Seattle. And as I walked in, there was people all over the floor, standing, sitting. It was filled with people. Now, in our email that we were sent to confirm our audition, we were told not to bring friends or voice teachers or producers or anyone else like that. But of course, people did. The room was filled with people that were there to support their singers. So as we were standing around waiting or sitting, we were there for actually several hours. We checked in at the check-in table. They took some information, but they were running behind. So we just kind of had to hold on in this kind of tight room. And so when I was there, I, as a voice teacher, like to kind of check out and watch what's going on. Now, let me cut to the chase right away. I did sing, but I was not passed on, which is why you're watching this video. If I made it through the first call, I would have to sign a disclaimer, and I couldn't talk about what happened. But since I didn't make that call, I am going to make this video so I can help you prepare. If you choose to make this voice audition and you make it to the second call, the callback audition, you will know what to expect. And had I had seen a video like this, I would have made some different choices. So that's what I want to do, is try and help you. So I walk in the room, it's filled with people, and we just kind of have to hang out. So first of all, I realized I was completely dressed differently than everyone else. I was wearing kind of a nice singer dress. It was a sleeveless, fitted, kind of above the knee dress. Definitely something that would be appropriate on stage or even in a restaurant. It wasn't overly stagey, but no one else was dressed like that. Everybody else was wearing jeans, rock and roll clothes, lots of black. So right away, I had a feeling that I probably was not what they were looking for. Now, the irony of all that is when you go on the show, you're all glammed out, you got your clothes, but what I found was that is not really the way to dress. So let me tell you what happened to me and what I recommend you do. First of all, I prepared doing music that I thought was going to show off my voice. I'm a power belter. I have a huge range. I'm classically trained. I've sung pretty much every style of music. So I thought it would be best for me to show off what I do best and look good, look like I deserve to be on stage and I belong there. And I wasn't really wearing anything different than what people wear on that show. And I wanted to show that I had the chops to pull it off. Now, what I found, although that's really standard operating procedure when you want to audition with your strength and show off your voice and look good, that for this TV show, that actually is a bit over the top. What they're really looking for is not amazing talent, great voices that are crazy, but they're looking, it's all about the TV show. It's about good TV. And so what I found with the voice is actually even fairly narrow. It looked to me as I sat in that room waiting to audition that they were looking for rock and rollers. The people that came in and had a guitar player play with them, or they played guitar themselves, were actually getting put through to the next level more than the people who sang for the tracks. While I was sitting in the room, there was a young R&B singer who looked good, had a great look, and she was actually being talked up by this producer guy, I'm assuming, one of those people that probably shouldn't have been there, but was there to support his clients or his friends, and he liked this girl, and he kept talking to her and asked her all these personal questions. And she handled it really well, but I could tell from listening to them that she had been doing some performing in Seattle and had a following and had done some singing. And so as I watched these people go in and out of the room and how they walked out, it was really apparent to me that the rock type people with the guitars were getting put through, where this girl walked right out of the room after one call. And it seemed to me, at least in the Seattle room, in the Seattle edition, that they were really looking for R&B singers. Perhaps they wanted to turn the show in a different way. A lot of times with these shows, they have an agenda. They don't want to look for a certain type of singer. They want to look for another singer. So my impression was the rock and roll voice, the singer-songwriters, guitarists were really more what they were looking for. This girl, although she looked talented and probably had already a following, they weren't interested in R&B singers from what I observed. And of course, everybody at this edition was a callback edition. We're no bad singers. Everybody had passed the initial video call through first. So everybody had already been pre-screened. Everybody could sing. Everybody looked good on camera. So that was kind of my first thing. As I got into the inner room, right before I went in, I actually was able to hear even more of who went in. I could hear the singers in the room and heard them come out. And to be honest, as a voice teacher, many of the singers that I heard that got asked to the final round or the next level were, to be honest, average to me. I didn't hear any really exceptional voices that were outstanding. They were just good enough. But they looked good. They looked nice. They had this pop look. And so they were sent through. Where some of the more power voices, the belters, the big voices were given a pass. Now, so what I suggest to you as you go in and prepare for this show, don't go and show that you have a big voice. Don't go for the big sound. Definitely don't sing an old song. I think that is really key. I went in and sang an older song that I thought showed off my voice. But for this show, for The Voice, it's really best for you to sing something contemporary and modern. I would suggest within 2 to 3 years. And if you can have someone play the guitar for you, that also looks more authentic. You don't look as karaoke if you have someone who's going to play the guitar for you and you have that rock pop sound. I heard some fairly average people, but had a nice groove and a great personality. They got sent through. So I highly suggest you sing a modern song. And also, don't feel like you have to show all this big range. Again, in most editions, you want to show off your voice and do what you do best. But I think in this instance, although it's The Voice and the people on the show show off big ranges, what these reality shows want to do is find like the diamond in the rough. They want to show somebody who has maybe some aspects and they want you to grow into something. So if you come to the audition with everything together, including looking all styling and having an awesome song and a great voice, it's really not what they're looking for. They're looking for potential. They're looking for someone that they can polish up on the show and make it sound interesting. Again, what I was talking about, what I wore, this dress really wasn't out of line. It was something that would be fine in any restaurant. It was a great dress, but I think if you're going to go into that show, it's best to wear something more like what you wear at a coffee shop. If you had a coffee shop gig, you know, jeans, a nice fitted shirt, nothing too glam, nothing too stagey, even though that's what you're going to wear on the show. I know it's really ironic, but I think you need to look a little bit more down to earth. And even if you have all this great stage experience and you know how to glam up on stage, don't bring it there, because you want them to discover it for you. I would actually downplay it just a bit. If I knew that, I probably would have maybe worn my jeans and maybe a fitted shirt and looked kind of more like a college student and sang some kind of song that was kind of Jason Mraz and just kind of showed some groove and some storytelling. That's really what they're looking for. Anything beyond that is way too much. And I think it's a better chance. Now, that said, I could have done all those things. I still don't think it's what they're looking for. And, you know, to be honest, I felt fine with it because I saw where pop music is. It's right here. And I'm, like, way past that. And I don't know if I really would be happy going to that narrow place so I could sing these very limited songs, which is where pop music is. Unfortunately, pop music isn't about the power voices. It's not about the divas. It's about making a marketable product. And they realize that they don't need to have that sort of talent to make a product. They just need to have a pretty face, a groovy beat, a melody that actually anyone can sing on the first listen. And if it's catchy enough and you got good lyrics, then you got a hit. And then my next year, everybody will forget about that hit. But it doesn't matter because money's being made. It's like McDonald's. So to go on these shows, keep that in mind. You know, go for a catchy pop song. Ideally, if you can have someone play guitar for you, don't overly dress up. Don't diva out. Just wear something that looks kind of stylish and modern. And also something that you can sit on the floor if you need to while you wait, because you might be waiting for a long time. So that's what I suggest. Modern song within 2 years. Don't try and show everything in that first song. Just show some personality and groove that you sing in tune, and you can sell a lyric. And dress in a way that's accessible, that you look good, but not overly stagey. And that's what I suggest. Go in there, give it a shot if you feel like you need to go, and have at it, because you never know. But if you don't get called back or you don't make the next call, don't worry about it, because it's really about what makes good TV. And here's the thing. The people that got the next level, because I sat in the room and I heard them, I was a little spy, what they told them, if they made that next cut, then they did a little interview work on camera to kind of see how they would interact on the camera, and then they'd sign another release, meaning they would talk about it. I didn't sign that, so I'm talking about it. And also, they were told that their name would be put in the potential pile, and if they didn't hear anything by March 1st, then they're out of the running. So basically, they just collect a whole bunch of people that they're interested in, and when it's all done, they sit down and they take a look at who they want to be on the show. And that decision is not about talent. It's about what makes an interesting show, or who do they think will actually sell the most records, or a combination of the above. So it's a TV show. It's not a talent show. They're not looking for the most talented singers. They're looking for interesting people for their TV show. So that was my experience. I hope you found this helpful. I'm looking forward to the next projects I get to do in the next year. And I hope that if you do go in audition for The Voice and you do make it to the callback, that you found this video helpful. A couple more things I want to be clear about the audition to help prepare you for what happens. Like I said, you had a big long wait. We had to sign in. They ask you to prepare 3 songs. If you bring an accompanist or you play guitar, they still want you to be on a track. You can either have it on a CD or you can have it on your phone or iPod. I highly recommend burning a CD. I use my iPod, and it's really easy to have your track screwed up. And mine got a little bit messed up, and I regret not putting it on a CD. I think you can't screw up a CD. The guys that are running the sound aren't going to make sure everything's queued up perfectly unless you touch it, and a touch screen can get messed up. So bring a CD. Don't use your iPod if you don't want things to be messed up. Secondly, you prepare 3 songs. Don't assume you're going to hear all 3 songs. If they don't like what they hear the first time, they're not going to ask you for another. I made that mistake. I sang a song that I felt really comfortable with, thinking I would get a 3rd try. I should have known better. I know better, but I still did that, and it was an older song. So I wasn't able to sing my more modern song. So sing your best song. Sing the one that you want to sing. Don't start with something and hoping you'll sing your better song the second song. You may not get to sing that second song. Sing the best song first, because that may be the only one you want to give them. And also, make that your modern song. I start with the older song because I was more comfortable with it, thinking they would go, hey, I love it, let's hear the next one. They never did. Sing the more one song, sing the more modern song, and have that be the song that you're going to sing and offer that. Once again, the room was filled with people. Yeah, as I was saying, the room that we auditioned in was filled with people. Don't be shocked. I had about 5 or 6 people. There was 2 women. One was the primary producer. The other one was kind of making sure everybody was in the right place. There was a guy running the camera, a guy running your CD and turning on your music when you needed to, and someone else was on the computer. And there was another guy sitting there who I think was the studio owner. So there's quite a large room of people, and you're going to make your announcement to them. One person was in charge, and they are the ones that say yay or nay on you. And so make your best choices, and good luck. Talk to you soon. Bye.